Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to this episode of Jabber. I hope this video finds you all in good health and that you're all doing good. Me and my family, we are doing fine. As far as you can find... Jesus Christ, I can't talk. As far as you can do fine in times like these, of course, we are really living in interesting times, gentlemen. And if you don't want to hear me talk about Corona, the COVID jazz or blues, however you want to call it, and all the measures and restrictions and freedom-taking bastards that are working against us, the population, then you better stop this video right now and go watch one of my older videos, because this is going to be a little bit of a rant video when it comes to that. So, wherever you are living, you have noticed some of this crap. And in some countries it's worse than in other countries. But here in Holland, man, apparently, from what I've heard, we now have one of the worst lockdowns on the planet. We have curfews from 9 o'clock to 4:30. We have, the general 1.5 meters that we got to keep. We've got mouth caps. We've got it's still voluntary. They call it voluntary still, but if you don't take the vaccine, you're going to get more and more restrictions, apparently, as they seem to be doing it right now. And they're trying to coerce you to take this vaccine for a virus that, of course, now that the numbers are out after a year of this crap, is no more than a very heavy flu season with a little bit more intensive care bed takage. But our government has had a year to provide more intensive care beds. But of course they didn't do anything, because if they're empty, that is a shame of all the money, they say. In the meantime, we have heavy lockdowns and all the shops and all the entrepreneurs are shut down and going bankrupt. And this is not gonna cost more money than, let's say, 500 IC beds with personnel that we gotta keep. How much could that possibly cost compared to destroying our society? And we are destroying our society, gentlemen. There is nothing more to say about this stuff. Not only are we all losing our freedoms, our jobs, our businesses, our health and the sanctity of our children, meaning that, for example, in our schools right now in Holland, and I know this can differ with other countries, but in our schools, children are not going to school above 12 right now. Below 12 they are. But if one of these kids in one of these classrooms get a positive test, and the whole classroom has got to go home for 5 days, and if you are not willing to let your child be tested, even if your child doesn't have any complaints or any symptoms, then your child needs to stay home for 10 days. And so if after 12 days after that another child tests positive, then your child got to stay home again for 5 days. And if you again don't want to let him or her be tested, you're at home again for 10 days. So this is coercion. This is trying to get people to get the vaccine, trying to get people to give their children the vaccine. And this is a problem, because we have vaccines right now that are highly suspect. They haven't been tested on the long run. They are also experimental. They are mRNA and mDNA vaccines that are available right now that are highly risky. They have never been given en masse like this to populations. And we're taking a huge risk. I don't want to give my child this stuff, nor do I want to give myself this stuff. And, maybe then if I don't take it, I will not be able to fly or go abroad or go on holiday. Maybe I will not be allowed in public transportation. Maybe I will not be allowed to do my job in healthcare. And so we are all slowly being forced to take this stuff. And in Holland, we have in our base laws, you call it constitution in America, we have something like that as well. We have a thing called self-beschikking in Dutch. I mean, it means basically that you can make your own choices when it comes to your health and your body. And this is in our ground laws, in our constitution. But yeah, and they cannot at this moment go around that yet when it comes to laws. So it is not officially mandatory, this vaccine, because of that reason, because of it's in our constitution. But they are trying to look for ways to get around it. And I don't know about you guys, man, but I am starting to get worried because these are supposed to be our representatives. And even if I did not choose for them, they are supposed to take care of their people, not take care of the pharmaceutical industry. And I find it intensely funny that there's still a lot of people that are not seeing this stuff. There's so many people still that don't see this, that actually think the government needs to be more strict. For what? For a coronavirus with a mortality rate of 0.23 compared to a mortality rate of a heavy flu season of 0.20? That's a 0.03 difference. A coronavirus that is still in the A category of viruses with those numbers, together with Ebola, together with the Black Death, the plague, together with cholera, all viruses that have a 30, 40, 50 or higher percent death rate. And there is corona in between those with a 0.23. Fantastic. And for this reason, we are changing our democracies to something that I would call dictatorships. Or maybe we would still call it soft dictatorships, because they are not enforcing it with weapons yet and with concentration camps. But how far away from that are we? I mean, I don't have any faith anymore. I've lost it. I think we need to get the hell out of these situations and vote for the parties that want something different. But I'm hoping. Of course, it's being suppressed as well in media and stuff like that. The media is completely toting the government line, completely idiotic. And so are all the television shows and all that, all the newspapers. But they're all in the same hands, right? So that's no surprise there. But anyway, in the meantime, our elderly people are dying alone, cannot have any visitors, are lonesome, and are slowly being phased out that way. We have our children who are getting used after this year, getting used to mouth gaps, not being able to see people's facial expressions, from which they take a lot of their understanding of what people mean. 70% of our communication is nonverbal. This is being taken away from learning for our children how people look and what it means. This is going to have major impact on our children. Our children cannot go to school, cannot go to events, cannot go to their sports. Neither can we, by the way, but that's another matter. Then we cannot keep our businesses open. Entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs are being slowly squeezed to death. Their businesses are being bought over by big companies, and when we come out of this, we will have nothing left but big companies, no more private businesses. And this is going to be devastating as well for the economy. We're going to have an underclass, we're going to have an upper class, and we are not going to be in the upper class yet, I can tell you that. Billionaires have increased their wealth by about 25% in the last year. Everybody else has only lost money. We are being ruled by some billionaires, Bill Gates and his cronies, Klaus Schwab from the World Economic Forum, who tell us that pretty soon we will own nothing and we will be happy in their new thought-out society. How they're going to reach that, I don't know, but I can guess. And what about the people that don't want to go along with that stuff? What are they going to do with that? So I told you a lot of stuff. You can look up Klaus Schwab. He's wrote books about this stuff. This is not a conspiracy theory. Bill Gates has talked about this as well. He's talked about that we're going to have to get used to keeping these masks on at least until 2024. And these guys are full of it, man. And if you don't understand this stuff yet, if you're not concerned about the psychological health of our children, of our elderly, and of our entrepreneurs and other people that are losing their jobs, then you just don't get it. You just don't get it. You're just not seeing it. And you are actually working towards this this end goal with these people, even if you don't really know it. But you're a collaborator in that sense. I'm getting more and more rough with these people. Who say, but oh, the government, they're good for us and they want to help us. Yeah, they want to help. Fuck that. They want to help the pharmaceutical companies and the the lobbies that got to them, not us. They're not sitting there for us. And if you are helping these people by silently giving your support, then, well, you're a collaborator to me. Just like the people who helped the Germans in the Second World War were collaborators. Nothing more, nothing less. People gotta wake up. And if you don't, you will find yourself in a different world all of a sudden. And you will say, but I didn't know. Well, guys, the signs were there. You can see it if you want to see it and if you open up your mind. Anyway, guys, thank you for listening to this rant. It's not making me more happy, this stuff, and I'm pretty sure it doesn't make any of you more happy either. It is a rough situation that we're in, and we're the generation that's gonna have to fight for our freedoms and for our democracy that was handed down to us by our ancestors. Let's not have it go to waste, gentlemen. We gotta fight for this stuff. And I mean, fighting, probably not take up arms, although if that's necessary in the end, I might be willing to do that, although even though in Holland we have been disarmed, so that's going to be difficult anyway. But in all other ways, I'm going to peacefully go against these rules and going to give some resistance, because we're going down the shitter. Wake up, gentlemen and ladies. There is ladies watching. Wake up, people, because we are going down if we're not careful. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.